Kumustas, Philippines! I am Soren and you are watching this interview on ABS-CBN Entertainment. Stuck here, waiting for why? What's here but a whole lot of nothing?
So why don't we run to all the things that we want, yeah? Hello, Mga Familia! My name is Richard Juan and today we are doing a very special interview for ABS-CBN Entertainment. In today's interview, I am going to talk to an incredible K-pop artist. She's part of the K-pop girl group CLC and recently she released her chart-topping solo single titled Run. Mga Familia, I am so excited to have with us today, Sorn. Hi, Sorn!
Hello, Richard. It's really nice to be able to do this interview with you today.
Thank you for gracing this interview all the way there in Seoul. My first question for you is, Soren, you recently released your solo single Run and it topped various charts all over the world. How does it feel that your first solo song achieved something so incredible?
So for my first single, I was really happy to be able to top chart a lot of charts because to be honest, for my first single, I wasn't really hoping for much. My goal was to just release music for my fans to listen to because I've never done anything like this before and I know that a lot of people were waiting for it. So it's still very overwhelming, but I mean, it's a really good start and it really encourages me to release more music in the future and I really hope that I'll be able to do it.
So why did you choose Run as your first single?
So I chose Run as my first single because I wanted to do a music where everyone can relate to. I personally really, really like R&B music, but I knew that a lot of my fans won't be able to, you know, follow up with what I like because I'm really deep into R&B. So I wanted to do like an easy listening vibe type of music so that everyone can relate to, everyone can listen to. And personally, I think that music that you listen to while you're driving is the best type of music.
Can you share with us a little more on the process of creating Run? From the songwriting to music production and to the promotions, how hands-on were you for the whole process?
For creating this whole project, it was a really long journey. I actually started planning since last year, but because of timing, we were able to do it in March. And yeah, I was able to do everything by myself. And also I got a lot of help from the team from Wild. Everyone kind of helped on making the concept and helped guide me with everything. I was also contacting Candace because Candace is in LA, but I was able to talk to her to see what she had in mind, what the concept was like for her while she was writing this music. I mean, I was really hands-on on everything, and everything that you guys have seen throughout the past month has came out from this little brain right here. So yeah, I tried my best to put all of my creativity into the project and also use my experience as a CLC member for the past 6 years to really take action, and I was able to do everything front and back. So yeah, it was really personal for me.
I super loved your music video Run and it channels this very free-spirited vibe. So who conceptualized the video and what made you decide to choose this style for your first solo music video?
So as you guys can see from the music video, I was able to go to Jeju, which is an island on the southern part of Korea. The reason why I chose Jeju as the location for filming is because, I don't know, when I was listening to the music, I mean, the music gave me such a free spirit vibe, so I wanted to go to like have like a location where it's more of like an outdoor vibe, and I personally really like nature.
So you mentioned Candace earlier, who's based out there in LA, and I know she's a songwriter who actually did various songs for BTS, and she wrote Run for you. What was your reaction for the first time when you read the lyrics of the song?
So when I heard that Candace was going to write the song for me, I was really happy because I know that Candace is such a talented person. She's so talented, and I also heard her songs that she wrote for BTS in the past and I was always her fan. And also for her, Candace wrote this when she was in love. So I don't know, for her she told me that it was like a romantic song that she wrote, but for me when I first got the song, how I interpreted the song was that it wasn't like a romantic song for me, but it was more like, I don't know, like running away from whatever society tells you. So I wanted to encourage a lot of people who has like who had a dream before and who's not able to accomplish that to kind of like stand up for themselves and just kind of fire up that fire in their heart again. And also for younger audience who are starting their life right now, I thought that run really kind of brought that message out really clearly. So I just want to pass that on to inspire younger and older audience of mine to stand up for themselves and follow their dreams.
Releasing your first song after being part of a group for years is such a huge leap. So what made you decide to take that leap?
I decided to release my first ever solo song because I thought it was time to do it. I've been with CLC for 6 years and I thought that all the experience that I had in the past and my social media that I built up this past year was just kind of like ready to release something by myself on my own. So I don't know, and all my members were really encouraging me to do it because they all know that I have passion for music. I love to sing and like that type of character who've done things by myself all the time. So they're like, I mean, if someone had to release a solo music, then it makes sense that I do it. So they were really, really supportive from beginning until now. And yeah, that's why I decided to do it.
What's next for you after Run?
I'm actually working on a new music right now, just planning this and that. I don't really know if we're gonna release it or not, but I'm really trying my best to come out with a better and a more like dope upgraded version of Run, because Run was a big success for me as a solo artist and I just wanted to release something that would top that.
How about a collaboration with another artist? Is that something you would want to look into also?
That's for sure. I know that these days K-pop, the market itself has been, a lot of artists are doing a lot of collaborations, like Chungha is doing collaboration with DJs and other Western artists, and I really, really want to do that too, like, you know, Blackpink with Selena Gomez. I hope to be able to link K-pop with some other type of music from other side of the world, maybe interact with maybe some Filipino artists. That would also be really a really cool concept because I know that there's a lot of talented artists out there.
All right, Soren, last question before I let you go. Do you have a special little message for your Filipino fans?
So to my fans in Philippines, I would like to say thank you so much for giving me loads of support. And it's been a long time since we went to Philippines. We went to the Philippines once and I had a really good experience with my girls. It was like, I can't remember. I think it was 4 years back. And you know, my dad, he graduated from the Philippines, so he could speak Tagalog really fluently too. So I've heard a lot of stories from him when he was in college, and like, I really want to go there and experience the food. And like, I love Filipino food a lot. It's really similar to Thai food. So when I was there in the Philippines last time, I really felt like I was home. And I really want to go and visit again and actually like interact with my fans closer and share the experience and everything. So I hope COVID gets better so that I can go visit y'all over there.
All right, thank you so much, Soren, for such an insightful interview.
Well, that was a great, great interview. I had so much fun, Richard. Thank you so much for interviewing me today. And maraming salamat ka pamilya. And continue to listen to Run on all types of music platforms. And I hope to see you guys soon. Bye.
There you have it. Thank you so much, Soren, for your time. And thank you all to our kapamilya for watching this. Until next time.